Welcome to SpaMedica.com TV. My name is Dr. Stephen Mulholland. Good to see you again. I see many patients who come to SpaMedica and come to see me complaining of skin issues, texture, inflammatory scars, irregularity, large pores, and wrinkles. What do we do with wrinkle-challenged, texture-challenged skin? There's been a whole boom and explosion in high-tech ways, fractional lasers, fractional radio frequency devices, tighteners that can give you the kind of skin that you've always hoped for. Let's take a look at one such individual.
Safe to say, a lot of people want to look younger, but they don't necessarily like the idea of having cosmetic surgery. Diane is one of those people, so she went to Dr. Steve Mulholland for some other solutions.
Okay, Dr. Mulholland's ready to see you. So
terrific.
Bring you right in.
Diane Armstrong is a prototypical type of patient that I would see. She's a working woman. She's active in business. She's got an active social life. She feels young. She diets. She exercises. Despite all her efforts, she looks in the mirror and she goes, oh my goodness, who is that? Thankfully, nowadays, we have so many options for these people to look great without a big operation.
I have all these little hereditary kind of lines that I think he calls them marionette lines here. They're not that deep, but you know, they're there, and I teach fitness classes and I'm in front of people for business as well. So those kinds of things I'm noticing more as the light shines on them. It's like, all right, and I don't really feel my age. So I'd like to see those things. I think it would just tighten it up and make you look a little more fresh and alive looking without having to have surgery.
Good to see you again, Diane. Good to see you.
How are you? Good.
I'm excited?
Yeah, I am excited.
Well, come on, let's chat a bit about our procedure today. Come on in and have a seat. Some of your concerns and issues about what you don't like are, number one, loosey-goosey skin under here.
Yes.
some lines and wrinkles around the mouth, the cheek, and the brow.
Right.
And then as we've aged, we've lost a little bit of volume under the eyes and around mm-hmm. the mouth, so we look a little sunken. And so we're going to address all of those today in this combination of non-invasive things. So, okay, Diane, come on in to our procedure room here, and I'll get you nice and comfortable. I'm going to slowly bring back the volume in your under eye that age has taken away. Okay, perfect. Now I'm going to compare both sides, make sure they're looking great. Look this way. I'm looking at the shape and the structure. I'm really happy with what we're bringing out. Things are looking great. Now we're going to go after granny mouth. So I'm going to position the laser now. We'll finish off with the Botox. It's going to look great. 5 years younger in 30 minutes.
I like it.
Was that typical example you hear about you know, a woman who looks in the mirror and she's not seeing who she feels like, and she just sort of wants to get rid of some of those lines. What is amazing, and people are going to be in awe when you see the after photos, all of this was done without cutting. There was no cosmetic surgery involved. Walk us through exactly what you did. We saw the laser on her face.
You're absolutely right. Many patients want to look great, but they don't want that a knife-based experience. And we're in a wonderful age right now in plastic surgery enhancement where we don't need to do that. So she was an individual that I see many women like this each week, where we do about 45 minutes of treatment. You saw a little bit of laser. There's some needle-based treatments, some Botox, some new fillers that will last a couple of years, and then some skin tightening techniques. Rather than throwing away skin, just going under the skin and tightening it.
Right.
And all that can be done, as you can see, under local anesthetic without the risks of general. And then perhaps, you know, 2 or 3 days off and you're back into the fray.
So what I was asking you was, did any of that hurt? But she's frozen.
Yeah, so there's always discomfort. To say it's painless is usually not being honest with the patient.
Yeah.
The pain comes from having some anesthesia, so there's a little bit of local, like if you're at a dentist and they're freezing your gums, mm-hmm. your teeth. But once the freezing's in, and that's a couple minutes of discomfort, then there's really no pain.
Now, I can imagine a lot of women would be into having, you know, injections and laser treatment if it's going to make them look as good as Diane did and avoid sort of the really invasive surgery. But How long do these injections actually last? And talk to me a little bit about maintenance.
So in years gone by, we would do an injection. You'd have to come back every 3 months. That's mm-hmm. not practical for a working woman, for any woman really, who wants to keep going back. Now we have long-term solutions, injectable Voluma type products that will last for 2 years. Botox techniques that means you come in twice a year. And a lot of these laser techniques are good for years. Mm-hmm. So I sum it all up for most patients. If you don't want a facelift, and there's still some that do, but for those that don't, you can look at about 5 years younger in less than an hour, and it's going to last you at least a year. And so let's say you buy a car, you have a house, mm-hmm. you just kind of look after it. You do a little gardening, you put a little gas in the tank, so there's some maintenance, but it's very affordable maintenance, and to look 5 years younger in perpetuity is a very strong message for people.
Can we talk a little bit about price?
Yeah, so if you're going to go for the whole 5 years younger, you're looking between $3,000 and $4,500 in most practices. So I usually, again, say, well, it's less than $1,000 a year. So how much is a year? What value is it to you? Yeah. And it's got to be affordable in this economy. It's got to be safe, effective, and last.
Okay, so take a look at these shots right now that we have. We're showing a picture of the before and after of Diane. This is from the side. A huge difference here. This is the overall. You can see it mostly here in the eyes, though.
Yeah, if you look at the overall picture, her skin is tighter, it's firmer, she's got appropriate volume, but she still looks natural. She doesn't look done.
That's right.
And many women are just afraid of looking at, like a character, like they see on the cover of Us, We, Now, Them, these horrible before and afters. She looks like herself, but at least 5 years younger.
Now, I know that there was some work done as well in the jaw area. What did you do there?
There's some very new devices that even if you don't have any fat, we can go under the skin, under local, like you do with Diane. It's called Nectite, and we can tighten the skin just by heating the undercarpet. So by heating the undercarpet, we induce a contraction, if you will, and look at the difference in her neck.
Take a look at that. So you basically went in there with a very small incision.
Less than 3 millimeters. We didn't remove any skin. We just induced her skin to become younger and get more elastin and collagen.
Yes.
And so these types of neck tight, face tight procedures are very popular because there's no scalpel used.
Right. Now, is there ever a time when you should not consider doing procedures like this, or is there an age that you're too young to start doing these procedures?
I think...
should you start in your 30s? Should you wait till your 60s? Should you not be doing this in your 70s?
Excellent question. So when is it age appropriate?
Yeah.
You know, everybody ages differently. We have hereditary issues. We have life environmental issues.
Yeah.
As soon as you start to see signs of wrinkles or deflation, mm-hmm. either grow old gloriously with that and celebrate it, mm-hmm. or then you start to fight it. And when you start to fight it, simple things done a couple times a year, and you could look really 5 years to 8 years younger for the rest of your life. I think we're entering a period where you don't need to do a scalpel or knife-based surgery to look great forever. And great to me is 5 to 8 years younger than your stated age.
Yes.
So if you're 55, you're always looking 48. If you're 65, you're looking 58.
I like the sound of that. How old is Diane? Do you mind?
Diane is in her mid-50s. She's about 56, and she looks a good 48, 49 when
Absolutely.
She emerged out of that. Yeah.
Do you see a day when people will, you know, decide in the morning that they want to get some of these procedures done over the lunch hour and you know, get some laser done and have a sandwich and go back to work? Just seems to be so easy. You'd think that the entire procedure, it used to be a very big deal to get work that had that kind of impact. But to see her looking this good and knowing that she took maybe 2 or 3 days off afterwards, it almost seems conceivable that this sort of cosmetic enhancement can become so easy, like a daytime thing.
Yeah. I think a daytime is realistic. A lot of companies promote the lunchtime makeover.
Yeah.
You need to take the rest of the day off at least, and preferably a weekend.
Don't go back to work that day.
Unless we get something miraculous in the sandwich that turns back the clock, you still need to take some time off.
All right. When you do get these clients that are coming in, if someone were to come in and say, okay, I would like to get a facelift, is there ever a time when you say to them, you know what, you don't need to be that invasive. We can do the same things you want and use technology that is not going to be that invasive?
That's a great question. Usually when I meet someone, I ask them, are their goals to look their best? Are they interested in surgery or non-surgery? Almost everybody says, well, show me what non-surgery can do.
Yeah.
I show them in the mirror what we could do with these non-surgical techniques, show them some before and afters, and many patients will go, wow, I can do that without a facelift? I'm there.
And absolutely.
But there's some patients who, you know, if you leave it too long, if the car is too broken down, the house is too dilapidated, you need to renovate a little more intensively.
Yeah.
But the vast majority of patients I see now are between, say, 30 and 50. They're looking pretty good, and they just want to keep looking gooder.
Yeah.
Without anything invasive. Wow, beautiful skin at the speed of light. That's truly what it's become. With a high-tech approach to attractive looking, smooth, even bright skin, between photo facials, intense pulse light, lasers, fractional radio frequency devices, thermage, we have a whole host of non-excisional options to give you beautiful skin. Of course, sometimes I'll combine lifts and tucks and volume and inflation with fractional lasers to give you that 3D deflation, descent, deterioration, rejuvenation. It truly is something you need to come in and see an expert for. So visit me on spamedica.com, look down the problem list, look up the procedures you may be interested in, and I look forward to seeing you live and helping you achieve beautiful skin at the speed of light.